Shane Dawson has been forced to apologize for some disturbing remarks he made on his podcast back in 2015. Some people are saying that this audio clip is bad enough that it could end Shane Dawson's career. We are going to talk about it right now on IO. Welcome back to another Inform Overload video, I'm Charlotte Dobre. Twitter is buzzing about Shane Dawson's latest apology. On March 17th, a Twitter user tweeted a clip from a Shane and Friends podcast. The tweet said, "Can we just stop supporting Shane Dawson? To me, blackface, pedophilia, or bestiality is never a joke." Which is like, yeah, those are some pretty serious accusations. The Twitter user is referencing last year when Shane was accused of pedophilia, and also after making controversial jokes in the same podcast. Shane also had to apologize for this in a YouTube video. So this subject is pretty touchy. There's not a whole lot we can say in this video without risking a strike or demonetization. But if you want to listen to the clip of Shane, there's a link posted in the description of this video. Once you listen, you will probably agree that it's bad. Like, at first when I heard about this story, I didn't think there was anything to it. Of course Shane Dawson would never do anything like this. Like, come on, it's just a joke, right? But then I heard the podcast and I was pretty taken aback. Essentially, on this podcast, Shane Dawson admitted to sexually abusing his cat, or joked about it. The clip went viral almost immediately and has racked up 252,000 views. Of course, a lot of people demanded an explanation from Shane, so Shane Dawson apologized in a series of tweets, several of which I won't read out for the subject matter, but here's what I will read. He said, "I've apologized many times for all the dumb stuff I've said in videos and podcasts over the years. I've learned my lesson over and over again, and I'm more confident now in my ability to be entertaining by just being myself and not being so shocking for laughs. That story was fake and was based on a dumb, awful sketch idea I had years ago that I never made, thank God. And when the opportunity came up for a funny moment in the podcast, I told it as if it was a real story, which was disgusting and very dumb." Last tweet, "My goal with the podcast and with my videos years ago was to tell shocking stories that would make people laugh and scream, 'Oh my God, no you didn't,' and think I was so crazy. It's embarrassing and I hate myself for it." There were a few more tweets, but that's the gist of Shane's apology. So how true is this for those of you who aren't OG Shane Dawson fans? Close friend of Shane Dawson and YouTuber Garrett Watts has gone on Twitter to publicly defend Shane. He said in a tweet, "As someone who knows Shane intimately, I can tell you that the shock style of comedy of Shane's past is the least interesting and least genuine side of him, and to see what he's grown into from what he used to be has been truly incredible." Andrew Sawicki also tweeted in defense, "Shane Dawson is a popular creator who makes great content. Does the internet think it's not possible for him to be a good person as well? Because he's the most sincere, caring, accepting, down-to-earth person I've ever met. Sorry to ruin someone's day, but it is what it is." He followed up with, "The Shane Twitter stuff is the greatest display of misplaced energy I've ever seen. This is not hot tea. This is not warm tea. This is old, recycled, artificial frozen tea. Really? Out of all the people to try and cancel for an old, edgy, throwaway joke, I can't." So I honestly don't know what to think about this at all. As someone who's passionate about comedy, I understand that sometimes comedy crosses the line. Shock value is a comedy technique. Telling a joke where the punchline is unexpected is a technique. And I like to think that I'm pretty understanding, especially when it comes to comedy, because it's something I love so much. But even this joke was a bit far for me. Like, I don't think that Shane did this to his cat, but like, maybe it was the delivery of it or something. But yeah, anyways, I cringe pretty hard and it takes a lot for me to cringe at anything. I'm the queen of cringe, guys, you know this. Anyways, that might not be what you guys want to hear, but that's just how I personally felt. Listen to the recording and tell me what you think. Is this going to ruin Shane Dawson's career? For now, I'm gonna wrap up this video with some comment features. Jonathan Aguirre said, "What are you teaching my children?" Facts? Anime Obsessed said, "Wow, what are you teaching my children? Teaching us more than they do in school, to be honest. Thank you, IO."
You're welcome.
Juan C. Gonzalez said, "Why don't you have more subscribers?" I don't know, 1.2 million is like quite a lot. I'm content with that. Sister Quacking said, "Wow, Charlotte, your teeth are so white they blind me. Need some sunglasses, bruh?" Jerry Fergerberger said, "I'm gonna say the F word. Frick! You got me there, Jerry. Fergerberger. Welcome to the end screen, this means the video is over. To keep watching IO, click on this playlist. And obviously, if you enjoyed this video, you should leave a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so I can see you in a future IO video.